I have one $1 million question for you that I want you to answer to your mother, to your wife, Marissa, to your daughter, Anastasia. Was it worth it to you for $1 million to sacrifice your own father to get you here? Was that worth it to you?
Trish, I was outnumbered when Wu came up to me. He had Spencer, he had Tosh.
I asked you a question. I don't want excuses. I'm saying to you, heart to heart, friend to friend, human being to human being, answer the question. Is it worth it to you to be here to play a game for $1 million on your father's soul and memory? Yes or no? It's a $1 million question.
Yes.
Thank you.
Moments after this questioning, Trish casts her vote to award Tony $1 million and the title of sole survivor in the popular American social strategy game, Survivor.
The winner of Survivor Cagayan, Tony!
Survivor is a game that has historically required lies, deceit, and manipulation in order to advance.
The word I gave you was that if I can take care of you, I will. I'm sorry, I cannot.
If you gave me your necklace tonight, Cerise said you'd hands down vote for Amanda.
Sandra, that's for you. Jerry, that one's for you too.
Damn it.
So how does Tony manage to elicit such an emotional response from a woman who's tasked with judging who played the best game? The answer is simple. Nothing is off limits to Tony if he believes it can help him win the game.
I swear on my dead dad.
In this instance, he was successful. Hyperactive gameplay and constantly over-strategizing his position in the game, Tony Vlachos likely made thousands more moves in his first season, Survivor Cagayan, than was ever seen on the show.
If I didn't go around, running around, doing all the crazy things I've been doing since day one, I wouldn't be here.
And it was his performance in this season that made him an immediate Survivor legend and would allow him to go on to play two more seasons of the show, Survivor Gamechangers and Survivor Winners at War. But Tony's game is not without flaws. At first glance, Tony fits the mold of a first boot more than the mold of any Survivor winner that came before him.
Guy in the gray t-shirt, what's your name?
Tony.
What is it you like about being part of the Brawn tribe?
Well, we're gonna stomp on beauty and we're gonna stomp on the smarts.
We have seen characters like this before and they all have trouble making it out of the gate. A player like Tony is put on the show by casting with the intention of adding a jolt to the early portion of the game where he will likely flame out after just a couple of episodes.
If I tell them I'm a police officer, the first thing they're going to be thinking is like, this guy's strategical, he's tactical, he's probably sharp on his toes, he's very observant, and they're going to be right. They're going to think that. So obviously I'm a threat to them, so they're going to probably want to try to blindside me right away, and they'd be smart to do that.
So how did Tony manage to win the game?
The winner of Survivor Cagayan!
The winner of Survivor Winners at War!
Twice, and in dominating fashion. Tony is without question a remarkably impressive out-of-the-box player. But is he the best? Being only the second player to ever have multiple victories on the show, does that automatically vault him into the conversation as one of the top two players of all time? And if that's the case, how does he stack up against the only other multiple game winner of Survivor?
King of the jungle. I'm king of the jungle.
Is Tony Vlachos, in fact, the king of Survivor?
Two. Swung on and hit in the air to deep center. That ball is high. It is far. It is gone.
Like a home run hitter, Tony's either going to hit the long ball, get all the glory, be a hero, or Tony's going to strike out.
He got it!
Just look at where he finishes in his first three stints on Survivor. First place in Survivor Cagayan, Brains vs. Brawn vs. Beauty. Second eliminated in the full All-Star Season Survivor Game Changers. And then first place again in the all-winner season Survivor Winners at War. When Tony steps on the beach, it is all or nothing. But it goes deeper than just a win, a loss, and another win, because you cannot just view each of these seasons alone in a vacuum. Tony came away from each game and into the next one having learned something from his previous experiences. In Cagayan, Tony found success in hyperactive scheming to the point of turning on his own alliance to better his position in the game, allowing consensus targets Spencer and Tasha to advance deeper into the game with the intention of shielding himself with bigger targets around him, in turn taking out the likable people who maybe could overtake his power position even though they were loyal members of his own alliance.
Stop killing each other.
LJ, Travis spoken.
If we get rid of Spencer tonight, you and I are done.
I'm willing to work with you to get rid of Jeffra, but this is the only way it's gonna happen. People are gonna hate me, man, because I'm not gonna tell Trish, I'm not gonna tell Cass.
So you're gonna tell
you?
Tosh.
Not Tosh. You're gonna have to tell Tosh.
Jeffra, the Travis spoken.
He turned on his number one ally, Trish.
Here, and I'll swear my wife and my kid, it's me, you, and Trish. I swear my mother, I'm my dead dad.
And in the end, convinced Wu against his own better judgment to take him to the final two instead of the unlikable Cass.
We got no shot against Tony.
I know. Don't let him talk you into it, either.
I mean, gosh, I'd be the stupidest Survivor player taking Tony Wu in.
Me too.
Most ridiculous.
It's a brilliant yet ruthless way to play the game. Only someone like Tony could pull it off and balance a good enough social game to warrant a jury vote at the end.
Here it is.
Well, you're making an ass of yourself.
And she calls me an animal. So I had to talk to her like I'm an animal. So I said, yeah, 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 so she could understand me. And she got offended by that, Jeff. It's just a joke.
And when Tony hit the beach in Gamechangers.
Hey, you guys do nice. I'm out. I'm looking for the idol. Where's he going? He said, I'm out. I'm looking for the idol.
It was clear to his fellow castmates it was better to defuse the Tony bomb sooner rather than later.
I don't think it had to do anything with the game I played this time. I think it had everything to do with the game I played my first time. Of course I'm going to do my crazy little tactics with my spy bunkers and spying on them and running looking for idols, but everybody was looking for idols, so it was to try to hide that would be insulting their intelligence. So I told them, yeah, I'm looking for the idol just like you guys are. I can't hide. There was nowhere to hide. I can't hide behind my lies. I couldn't hide behind my truth.
Second person voted out of Survivor Game Changers. Tony, that's five. That's enough. You need to bring me your torch.
Sheep being led to the slaughter. Good job, Sandra.
That's what you get for plotting against me.
Good job.
That's what you get, and the queen stays queen.
We'll get to her in a second. Tony came into Game Changers with a reputation of someone who plays fast and did nothing to change that perception. He evolved the Spy Shack from Cagayan into the Spy Bunker.
Because they're going to be looking for Spy Shacks, they ain't going to be looking for an underground bunker.
And he openly searched for hidden immunity idols. These were two characteristics of Tony that led to a perception of a relentless, cutthroat player that he wrongly let continue into Game Changers. These are tangible actions that survivors can point to as sneaky, untrustworthy gameplay. And ultimately, his threat level in the eyes of his fellow competitors was far too high to let him continue on in the game. Tony's loss in Game Changers was crucial to his success in Winners at War.
You know, everything put together makes you the player you are, right? So adaptability is one thing. So I went into the game and I had all these fantasies that I wanted to fulfill out there before I got voted off. So that's why I went into the game like right away, just started doing my crazy nonsense. And so when I went into the new season, I knew it now was all winners. I said, okay, now I have a chance. So let me play properly. Let me just, you know, take what I learned from my first time, take what I learned from my second time, which was not much. I just knew how to get snuffed. But when I got snuffed, that's it. The game is over. You outplayed me. You outwitted me. It's over. No problem. Let's move on with life. So that's why I was like, you know what? It didn't hurt that bad. So, you know, I took that with me and I was like, you know, wherever I blindside and win as a war, I'm not going to take it that personal because it doesn't hurt that much. It's a game.
Winners at War is by far Tony's most impressive outing in Survivor. The competition around him was expert level, a season cast with only players that have the previous experience of winning the game. Tony used the prestige of his competition to his advantage.
I love the people I'm with. I've played with Siren season 28. Sandra voted me off the second time and I lost the game, so I love her for that.
Instead of playing the Tony Vlachos standard handbook seen in Game Changers, Tony elected to anchor himself to camp so that no one could accuse him of idle hunting or spy shack building.
So I said, you know what? Let me just build the ladder. Don't tilt it to the side because all the rungs will slide right off. We'll climb up and simply pick the papayas off the tree, simply walk down the ladder, simply go to camp, chop it up, and simply eat it. Simple as that.
He did this to subconsciously manipulate his perception as somebody who was outclassed by his competitors.
It was like all psychological for me in this season. I just wanted everybody to think that I'm dumb, I'm weak, I'm not a strategic. You know, I had to do that.
He made himself into a docile, loyal member of his alliance and used this time to forge bonds with players that he could use later in the game.
Who wants to fight me, man?
If it wasn't for the disastrous failure of Game Changers, I don't think Tony could ever have successfully identified the strategy or employed it.
Seven people.
All of those guys said yeah.
All good. Everybody.
Is it that easy though, guys, man?
In the police academy, you learn body language. You always want to be authoritative, so you have to look more authoritative. You can't be like this, and you're looking at people, you're under arrest. You can't do that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You gotta be on the high ground. So in the game, I would always walk on the lower side of the sand.
So the smaller target, less threatening, are the ones.
Or the lower profile.
Yeah.
You know, I would be looking at people. I would slouch my shoulders down. I would hold my hands like this all the time. I'm standing still instead of like this, like I was in Cagayan.
Once Tony made it deep enough into the game, he had his hooks dug socially into a majority of the players around him, as well as idols and immunity wins saving his back.
Tony wins.
Oh, come on.
His second individual immunity.
Not to mention the undying loyalty of his partner from Cagayan, Game Changers, and now Winners at War, Sarah Lucina, still left in the game to feed him constant information and talk through strategy with.
Shots were fired at my partner.
At me?
Yeah.
Who?
Jeremy was telling me you and Sophie.
Yeah.
So once I heard that, it's over.
Yep. Okay.
All right?
Hey.
All right.
By the time Tony bounced Sophie with a pure and perfectly executed blindside.
I promise, listen to me. I just talked to Nick. He's 100%. I gave my allegiance.
Why?
Because they were gonna blindside you, kid. Who's there? Everybody.
13th person voted out of Survivor Winners at War.
No.
Sophie, need to bring me your torch?
Pocket.
He had full control over the game and expertly rode his way to the end in a clean and dominating fashion over the best competition to ever be assembled. Tony took home his second victory.
The winner of Survivor Winners at War, Tony!
And is only the second player in Survivor history to win more than one season. Sandra Diaz-Twine is the only other Survivor contestant to have won two times. Although Sandra has played four times to Tony's three, the argument could still be made that the true queen of the game is in fact the anyone but me strategist, Sandra. Playing solid under-the-radar games in both Survivor Pearl Islands and Survivor Heroes vs. Villains, Sandra's without a doubt a solid and extensively knowledgeable player.
I would hate to go home with the idol in my bra. Give me just a second, Jeff.
You do not win Survivor by accident.
The winner of Survivor Pearl Island.
Sandra's wins may be underrated compared to Tony's, but they should not be considered less than compared to Tony. In order to win a game of Survivor, every single move that was made got that player to achieve a winning game.
You know what? I can get loud too, what the f-
Therefore, one way to look at the game is that the best player of each individual season was the one who won that season.
Think about it. Russell's the kind of person where if he finds out somebody's gunning for him, he'll take them out. If one of us is going next, we could put a bug in his ear that coach is gunning for him.
There is no one way to play and certainly no one way to win. Tony won by controlling as many aspects of the game as he possibly could, while Sandra won the game by playing in the shadows, constantly being overlooked by her competitors, but not by the jury.
To me, the reason I probably was able to get to where I am now is because other people had other agendas. They had other fish to fry. Nobody worried about Sandra because Sandra was weak.
Tony's approach has been known to backfire on a lot of other players, including himself in Game Changers. And it requires balls-to-the-wall gameplay that at any moment could collapse in on itself. Throughout Cagayan, Tony made countless errors that were almost irreparable.
Trish has been with me since day one. She's my closest ally. But if I do this, she might turn her back on me.
A lesser player could not have survived this strategy. Sandra's approach is dangerous because she is so unassuming.
I'm against you, Russell.
That if she is on a strong tribe early and can make it through the pre-merge, she is a shoo-in to go the distance. We have seen this strategy work countless times, and Sandra is the absolute best at this particular strategy.
I'm feeling wonderful because regardless, Russell's keeping me around because I'll never get a single vote. But I don't know about that.
Tony has only had one bad finish out of three, while Sandra has had two bad finishes out of four. But on the contrary, Sandra won her second season as a returning winner in an All-Star season, something we have already seen be a problem for winners in previous All-Star seasons. Tony won a season where someone on that cast was going to become the second player to ever have two wins.
Who will have what it takes to outwit, outplay, and outlast all the rest, and be crowned the greatest player of all time?
Does that mean that anyone who came out victorious would automatically be cast in this light as the greatest of all time? Maybe. But on the other end, you could argue that Sandra didn't make it to the merge in that season, and Tony played an absolutely masterful game. When looking at all seasons of Survivor as a whole, and ranking who are the best of the best players, it's hard to deny that Sandra and Tony are not there at the top two. Their experience alone, playing three and four times respectively, two wins apiece, and going up against some of the best competition that has ever existed on the show, puts them in the conversation as best of the best. But there are a lot of other capable players that cannot be left off that list. And who knows, in the eyes of some fans, maybe those players are better. But in my book, both Sandra and Tony are right there in the top handful of players to ever play. They utilize two vastly different styles of gameplay, but oddly enough, Sandra and Tony do not approach the game in a vastly different way.
I was also the person that if someone needed that extra vote, I was there. As long as it wasn't me, I was ready to give up whoever.
I'm not here to sleep, catch up on beauty rest. I'm not here to watch water boil. I'm not here to share stories with people that I don't even know, that I don't even care about. I came out here to play a game. I want to win.
The ideals that made these players famous, respectively, are two branches from the same limb.
I was just always there to take advantage of the situation and let the vote go in a different direction than my way.
At the end of the day, as long as the vote is not them, then the vote is correct. The problem persists. There's no one way to define why a winner is better than another winner. When looking at the winning seasons of Tony and Sandra in a vacuum, I think the argument is stronger on the side of Tony as the better player and better winner. I think if you ran the simulation on each of these four seasons 1,000 times each, Tony probably comes out on top of his two seasons more often than Sandra and hers. But for me, it goes back to not being able to just view these seasons in a vacuum. These players are people. They grow and get better and learn before and after each game they play. At the end of the day, Survivor is not about your percentage chance to win in a simulation. It is about right there in that moment, how did you perform? Maybe there is room at the top for both a king and a queen.
Water under the bridge.
It's been under the bridge.
Tony's legacy stands for itself, and wherever you may rank him in your personal list of top players, it cannot be denied that after Tony's performance in Winners at War, he is cemented as a top player of all time. And the way Tony did it is a way that everyone can get behind. The man grinded and never stopped working. Whether at the top or bottom, every decision, every conversation.
Only shield in this tribe right now is Tyson. That's it.
Every single step of the game was purposeful, and it all paid off. Thank you all for watching. If you like this video and would like to see more videos of this style, please let me know. I love Survivor and would love to make more videos about this game. Let's start a discussion in the comments. I would love to hear where you all think Tony ranks among the best Survivor players to ever play. And consider subscribing to Drop Your Buffs. I have tons of ideas for more videos. Leaving a like would be very much appreciated. And thank you all.